Let's do some 13th again. Okay, the statement was if x plus y plus z is equal to 0, we have to show x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. Okay, you know very well identity. What is the identity? X cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. This identity you know very well. Okay, now what is the next step? Just see carefully. We have to be given x plus y plus z is equal to 0. So it means we can put the value of first bracket that is equal to 0. So it will become our right hand side 0 into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. Product of these two. You know very well if a number is to be multiplied by 0, the overall answer will become 0. So we can say that x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to 0. It becomes 0. Now we have to keep x cube plus y cube plus z cube on one side and shift your 3xyz. When you will shift this minus 3xyz to just your right hand side, the sign will go change. Because you know the rules of this one. Plus will change into minus if it is to be changed the place. Means left will to right or right to left. Or multiply will change into divide, divide will change into multiply, minus will change into plus. So we are applying the same. So it will give you x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. Clear? Now let's do some 14th. 14th, we have to evaluate. The first part is minus 12 cube plus 7 cube plus 5 cube. Okay. Just see. What is the value of x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz if x plus y plus z is equal to 0. Let's calculate the value of first x plus y plus z. Okay, what is the value of x in this question? That is to be minus 12. And what is the value of y? That is 7. What is the value of z? 5. Now let's find x plus y plus z. That will give you minus 12 plus 7 plus 5 means 0. It means the if x plus y plus z is equal to 0, we know very well the cube of three terms will become the product of x, y, z with 3. So apply minus 12 cube plus 7 cube plus 5 cube, that will become 3 into minus 12 into 7 into 5. So do the product of the three terms with 3. As the one statement is of negative sign, in answer you will get also negative. The find the product. The product will be 1260 means 1260 with the negative sign is your answer. Clear? The second part will be done by you. Okay, some parts I am going to leave. That is to be done by you. If you face any problem, you can ask me. Okay, now let's do some 15th. 15th and 16th, they are just like earlier parts which we have already done. Whenever area is to be there, it means area contains two things, length and breadth. So it is the product of two dimension. Area is two dimensional. So we can say two identities or two quantities will be there. If he is saying regarding area, it means one is to be length, another is to be breadth. Okay, so it is given in 15th question, first part. Area is given 25a square minus 35a plus 12. Now, how to do? You have to make the factors. Two factors product means one factor is just indicates your length, another factor indicates your breadth. Okay, now factorize it. You know how to factorize? You have done in 2.4 exercise by splitting the middle term. Now you required the product. Product is 25 into 12. What is that 25 into 12 product answer? That is 300. So your product required, that is 300, and your sum requires 35. So your factors are 20 and 15. Okay. So you write 25a square minus 15a minus 20a plus 12. Same steps. Okay. Now you have to take common. Common in first two, that is 5a. That left with 5a minus 3. Next common is minus 4. You left with 5a minus 3. Clear? So the overall factors are 5a minus 3, 5a minus 4. As you are getting two factors, so one factor is indicates your length, another factor indicates your breadth. So if L is 5a minus 3, breadth is 5a minus 4, or vice versa. Vice versa means if your length is 5a minus 4, then breadth is 5a minus 3. You can write vice versa also. Clear? Similarly, 16th question, one part we are going to do, that is volume given to you, volume. As volume is 3x square minus 12x, it means when volume is to be there, volume is 3-dimensional. Okay, 3D means your L into B into H. Okay, so in case of this, you will get three factors. One indicates length, another indicates breadth, and third indicates height. So 3x square minus 12x, just see common. What is common? That is 3x into x minus 1. You are not able to do the factors more. So factors, you have to just take as three factor. One factor as 3, another factor as x, another factor is x minus 4. So you can take that L is your 3 unit, breadth is your x unit, and h is your x minus 4 unit. When you are taking dimensions, you must have to just mention the unit, but no unit is to be given here, so you have to just mention only u word that indicates unit. I think that unit is clear to you. I have explained the whole unit, that is second, and tomorrow we will start the new unit, that is coordinate geometry unit third. Clear? So you have to complete your unit 2 in your concern notebook. Bye, students.